I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports.
We should have a good one on tap here today. It's the Panthers coming in at 2-6, going up against the Raiders, who come in at 3-5. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault. And that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Oakland Raiders and the Carolina Panthers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. They come into this one knowing it's been a while since tasting victory. They've dropped four in a row.
Can they remember what it was like to win a game? In these types of situations, you're looking for someone to inspire you, and it doesn't have to be one of your best players either.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Raiders, they were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And Mr. Cooper, Amari, a headliner in this offensive unit.
Brandon, it's rare that you get guys so polished coming out of college, but Amari Cooper has carried himself like a pro probably since he was 6 years old. He is a terrific talent.
Looking to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. While he gets attended to, we'll step aside. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. To throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And out will come the leader of this offense. And that, of course, is their signal caller. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And incomplete to open things up.
Here we go! One, nine!
First carry for Christian McCaffrey. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Come on, let's go!
They'll look to throw. And a throw here, that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds at the 39. And a gain there of 11 yards.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
That one, 28 yards on the ground.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Come on,
back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey.
And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line.
The numbers for McCaffrey last week. 11 carries, 60 yards.
They've lost a bunch of games in a row now. They've got to start thinking a little bit differently, maybe a little bit outside of the box. Find other ways to move the football. I don't know if you're going to do it through the air or maybe change up how you establish your run game.
They'll run it here. This is Rodgers. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20 at the 15. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10.
Here we go! One, nine, five.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This is caught and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 12 more yards there and another 1st down.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that has to be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
From back at the 3 now, this is 3rd and goal. He'll look to throw. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. It's their quarterback. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a 1st quarter lead.
The losing streak had taken on a life of its own, and I think it infiltrates a team when you're on that much of a slide. But this group has managed to focus, come out early, and put a touchdown on the board. They look like they mean business in this one.
They do. Now the key, holding on to that attitude, because, man, that streak has been a struggle for them.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. And the last drive, the 1st drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit better.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Brendan Langley picks it, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Now on to
of the field. Here come the Panthers. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice, that it all came together. But I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10.
Let's go. One, nine.
They'll drop to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make it second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete.
Let's go! One, nine,
nine. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it, keeps possession. And the punter's on the sideline. Here's the field goal unit now to try an exceptionally long one. 64 was Matt Prater's record. This would top that by a yard. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. A first update now from Cleveland. And it's the Browns out to the early advantage. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And now here's a carry heading left. And he is knocked down from the side at the 41-yard line. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 12 carries, 58 yards.
Well, watching the film, we saw that things clicked pretty well for them in the running game last week. No reason to change in my mind. Continue to try and run the football, give it to them early and often in hopes of breaking down the defense so some bigger gains result as the game goes on.
They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Set up to throw. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Set him back 5.
Still third down.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Set up a throw. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Oh, the Panthers come hard and they block it. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So a special teams mistake on a long punt return.
And think about the momentum that leaks out after that play, right? It's built up, terrific return, everyone's excited, but that flag on the ground can bring it way, way back.
This is McCaffrey on the give. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Throw now on second and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the intended target, and it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
He'll drop to throw. And he showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be fourth down. And his kick is right there. It's good, and the lead moves to 10-0. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get 3.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them to just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Clock's running down. Now with a play clock at 4, we're going to get a timeout call. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Come on, let's go!
They're going to look to throw. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. There he goes, right side. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. Bottom line, he's got to figure things out. He's completed three passes, but two of them have been to the wrong team so far.
And when we talk about the best quarterbacks, we're usually talking about touchdown to interception ratio, aren't we? And 2-1 is acceptable, but the top line guys, 3-1 or better is what they're looking for. Now we're talking about interceptions versus completions. That's not a ratio should ever be in any discussion.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
I think they want to start getting back into this game. It behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. It'll buy some time right. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Out of the gun now on third down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Warren. He will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. It was pretty evident in reading everything, hearing these guys talk, that this was a deal they wanted to get done. They know how valuable he is to this team.
Absolutely a key component to what they do and what they do well. And if they want to continue to have success in the future, they knew they needed him, and they got the deal done.
And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
On first down, he'll drop the throw. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. In just 2 minutes' time, don't forget, we'll get you to Orlando for our halftime report. To bring it to you, who else but Larry Ridley?
Now that man knows his football. Go get him, Larry.
Second down, offense behind the sticks here. 2nd and 13.
Here we go. What? Nothing. What? Nothing. Touchdown. Let's round.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Around the NFL, we've got a second quarter score. The Jets have scored again, so they open up a 2-touchdown advantage. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He finds his target, Fuller. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. Back to throw here. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Fuller. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Let's go! Brian 38! Brian 38!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
The Raiders on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and five.
Let's go! Brian 38, flex round! Flex round!
He'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Warren. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Let's go! One, nine! One, nine! Flex round! Flex round!
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Letting one go deep for the end zone. Oh, and it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next year?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley.
Okay, so Larry apparently giving us the silent treatment all of a sudden, and we're going to skip ahead to quarter number three. Around the NFL, they're in the second in Philly, and the Eagles out in front early. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because
What you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from it.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. And they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Now a handoff as they run left side. Slips past him.
Where'd he go?
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. That good for 19 and a first down.
Really good, solid run right there, and they did it from a four wide receiver set. And if you're an offensive coordinator, they used to tell people, hey, we're going to throw the football. Now they use four receivers on the field to spread things out, give them more running lanes and more options. And also, it usually takes the bigger defenders off the field, makes the defense lighter and easier to run against.
Gun. They'll look to throw. The quick slant caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Will Fuller, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Carolina getting set to take the field. They've got to right the ship. They had a great first half, but the lead has really gone down. Now, you know, you always talk about the adjustment to the adjustment. They've got to adjust right here.
And I think a lot of it is just mentally. Get back to doing what you were doing well in the beginning of the game, but a lot of that is playing with that emotion and that sense of pride and fire. It sometimes goes away a little bit when you build up a lead. You think you've got it going, and you also think, at any moment, I can go ahead and go back to the way it was before. You and I both know it's not that easy once you get off the gas a little.
Yeah, they don't want to see this lead diminish anymore.
They'll look to throw here. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Pick up of 33 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
McCaffrey following the penalty, and he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Yard line. It'll be a gain of 18 on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down. The Panthers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 4.
Come on, let's go!
They showed off a nice juke of the defender, but the next wave there to bring him down. Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for three. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that will get the lead up to 14. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. This is taken near the 13. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. So out come the Raiders. Here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there. Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they? If you keep running it, eventually good things are likely to happen. It's been a hard go in this game today, hasn't it?
Yeah, this defense, they've met pretty much every challenge in front of them this afternoon.
They're still trying to run the ball, but they're not finding much space.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. It's the fullback. His first NFL reception goes for six. And the Raiders are back within a score. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
And you remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They use their fullback in pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Rathman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Panthers coming out now. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Here we go. One, nine, ten.
On play action, they'll throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. His sixth touchdown of the season, and the Panthers are able to grow their lead. Well, they went play action there and set it up nicely for him. I mean, he can flat fly, and they hit him downfield.
And it doesn't take much to create that extra bit of space that a guy of his speed needs. If you go...
Oh, this is blocked.
Hey,
as the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. And now here come the Raiders. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. Down, he'll drop to throw it. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Warren. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Here we go. What?
Now they'll run it on the toss, and he gets it down to the 32. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. To throw now on first down. Throw left side complete. It's Warren. And he'll be knocked down sideways. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
Back to throw. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Come on, let's go! Grand 38!
Looking to throw. Fuller brings it in over the middle. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. He'll look to throw, and that would not to be. It's incomplete, so they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Come on, let's go! What?
They'll drop the throw. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up fourth.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown, and frankly, that should have been another pick right there. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. They go play action here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it. What people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances, putting it a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked up.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. I don't know, he had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
The mental focus.
Yeah,
of the whole
that's
thing.
True.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. A very solid gain of 27.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game.
Yes.
Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. They'll set up to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A nice little screen. They get six on first down. They'll set up the throw. Flush to his right. And some room to work. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
They'll look to throw. His throw is going to be incomplete.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
Back to throw now on second and 10. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he gets it down to the 32. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. Try it here. He's back to throw. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. 8 yards on the pickup, and that'll be good for an Oakland first down. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Time running out here on the play clock. He'll drop to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some... And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Martavis Bryant, his first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders have cut it back to within a score. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
It'll be a pickup of 12 yards, and that'll bring up a third down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation and taking care of the football paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that blitz coming, and down he goes. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock.
Come on, let's go!
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And not much running room. Down to the 32. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that will add three more to their lead. It pushes it up to six. So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time.
What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. He's back to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Fuller. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. 23 yards on the play. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw. This one caught left side by Cooper. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. He'll look to throw. Fighting through. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Offense.
That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
To throw. Bryant with a catch right side. 23 yards on the play. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Here we go. 1-9. Ohio.
They'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Shaq Thompson in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. To throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So this defense, they looked a little shaky to start the drive, but bottom line, they're a play away from finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. They have a chance to end it right here.
And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Panthers are going to win the football game. First down, this is McCaffrey, and he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come.
Boy,